Hey, what's going on, guys? How is everybody doing? Xing Cho's path has led him from being one of the most underappreciated 4-star heroes at the dawn of Genshin Impact to becoming one of the top-tier supports in the game. Xing Cho is an academic, one who spent hours reading as a small child, though not without a mischievous side, and would often hide martial arts fiction books inside a hollowed-out textbook. Xing Cho strives to become the embodiment of the chivalrous heroes that he's read so much about. We'll be talking about the stats you should be prioritizing, how to build your artifact sets, what weapons he'll get the most performance from, and what talents you should focus on. We'll be judging these from a free-to-play level all the way up to an endgame primary hero. Before we begin, make sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, hit the notification bell so that you never miss a video, and join our Discord. Link is down in the description below. Now, with that out of the way, let's jump right into the video. Xing Cho falls into the category of what we would call a burst support or enabler. Essentially, these both water down to the same thing. A hero that has an ability that stays on the battlefield for an extended period of time, provides some kind of passive buff to your main DPS, or provides consistent elemental debuffs to be able to proc your team's primary reactions, all of which apply to Xing Cho. Xing Cho's primary use will be his consistent Hydro application while off the field through his burst. With its long duration and quick application, it makes the perfect pairing for a Vaporize, Freeze, or Electrocharge team. Don't let yourself think that that's all he is, though, because his burst does pack a lot of damage behind it and can be a big help when taking down high-health enemies in a one-on-one fight. He also adds a little extra utility, being able to prevent some incoming damage and providing a small amount of heals at the same time. He's not about to replace your healer, but can provide a bit more stability to your main DPS and allow you to play a bit riskier. Xing Cho also acts as a Hydro buffer, reducing the enemy's Hydro resistance upon unlocking the corresponding constellation, making him a perfect pair for any of your current or future favorite Hydro main DPSs. As a disciple of the Guhua clan and their martial arts style, Xing Cho has a natural fluidity to his basic attack, performing 5 consecutive strikes, with 2 of those being dual strikes. His charge attack unleashes a flurry of strikes, dealing 2 separate hits. An interesting little factoid is that both Xing Cho and Hu Tao are students of the same combat style. You can see this in their side-by-side comparison, as this weapon style trains those to be fluid in multi-weapon combat. Could that mean that we eventually get a hero similar to Child in the future that uses the same style and multiple weapons? A question for another day. Xing Cho's skill, Fatal Rain Screen, performs twin strikes dealing Hydro damage and creating the maximum number of rain swords depending on your constellation. These rain swords float in orbit around your active character and will increase your character's resistance to interruption, will individually break upon taking damage, reducing the amount of damage taken, and upon unlocking his first ascension, will heal the active hero based on Xing Cho's maximum HP. On top of the skill multiplier, 20% of Xing Cho's Hydro damage bonus will also be converted into damage reduction. While the skill does do a lot of damage and generates a large amount of energy, the downside is this attack's cooldown. At 21 seconds, his skill takes a very long time to come off of cooldown, which can be very problematic, especially if Xing Cho is the only Hydro hero on your team to generate Hydro energy, since that's the main reason to use him, to keep his burst active as much as possible. We'll be looking at ways to minimize this downside as we move further into his kit. Xing Cho's burst, Rain Cutter, is the primary reason to use him as a support on your team. Xing Cho summons illusory rain swords that rain from the sky up to your current maximum. These sword attacks will be triggered by your active hero performing normal attacks only, not charge attacks. His burst will also generate rain swords exactly as his skill does. This attack lasts for 15 seconds and is the main reason why Xing Cho is heralded as one of the best supports in the game, both due to its damage and consistent Hydro application over a 15-second window. Costing 80 energy, however, is a tall order, especially when paired with a skill that can only be activated once inside this window. This damage is further increased by Xing Cho's 4th Ascension passive, providing a 20% Hydro damage bonus, increasing his damage and assisting in damage prevention. For talent prioritization, Xing Cho's burst is the reason he is valued so highly, so make sure to get that leveled up as high as you can for optimal performance. His skill follows after that. Priority of his skill will depend on your weapon of choice, which we will discuss when going over weapons. His basic attack is essentially a non-factor. This attack will almost never be used and is not a primary aspect to Xing Cho's overall performance as a supporting hero. And as a 4-star hero, whenever he comes around on banner, I would highly suggest trying to get further constellations, as his constellations actually provide a ton of value compared to other heroes of a similar rarity. Xing Cho's first constellation increases the amount of rain swords his skill and burst generate, bringing the total up to 4. His second constellation extends the duration of his burst by 3 seconds, up to a total of 18 seconds, and also decreases the hydro resistance of enemies hit by this attack by 15%. Constellations 3 and 5 are typical skill and burst promotions. Constellation 4 increases the damage of Xingqiu's skill by 50% during the duration of his burst. And finally, Constellation 6 increases the damage of the third consecutive Rainsword attack from his burst, and also regenerates 3 energy when each attack hits an enemy, further assisting in his energy generation for the next round of his burst. As a burst support, Xingqiu has 2 artifact configurations that will provide his best overall performance, but it will depend on how you build your other supporting heroes, how you decide to build Xingqiu. Your main options are between a 4-piece set of Noble Sublime and a 2-piece set of Noble Sublime and a 2-piece set of Heart of Depth. The primary deciding factor between these two being if you already have another 4-piece Noblesse user on your team. Since these effects don't stack, you'll only want one of these users. Having a hero like Bennett on your team, you're better suited to put the 4-piece set on him, seeing that his burst cooldown is only 15 seconds and better lines up with the 12-second duration of Noblesse Oblige. If this is the case, it's better instead to gain a Hydro damage bonus to further increase Xingqiu's damage and to add to the damage prevention of his Rain Swords, assuming you haven't hit their cap yet. Alternatively, you could go with a 2-piece set of either the Scholar or Exile sets to further increase his energy recharge, but I typically only suggest this for early to mid-game players, as the stats of these 4-star pieces pale in comparison to a fully built 5-star piece, both due to the max level being 16 as opposed to 20, and the loss of an entire substat. For main stat priorities, to maximize the uptime on Xingqiu's burst, an energy recharge timepiece will help to ensure that after 20 seconds, Xingqiu is again ready for action. As much energy recharge as you can get will be beneficial, but 200% is a good target if you're looking for a goal number, though this changes depending on your weapon of choice. Hydro damage bonus will of course be our stat selection for our cup, and for his circlet, crit rate will probably make the most sense, but of course it does depend on your artifact's substats. Either crit rate or damage will work, whichever stat your particular build needs. As far as weapons are concerned, there is one sword that stands far and above the others and elevates Xingqiu from a standard burst support to an excellent burst support. Sacrificial Sword is Xingqiu's best in slot weapon. Normally, we're used to seeing a 5-star weapon in this spot. However, this weapon excels due to its passive ability being able to reset Xingqiu's skill's cooldown to get another use, generating more energy to fill up his burst gauge quicker. With further refinements, this weapon can provide up to an 80% chance to refund your skill, almost guaranteeing 2 skill activation. Due to this, you may want to prioritize his skill a little higher with this weapon, since we can potentially double his skill's damage output whenever Sacrificial Sword's ability procs. Having energy recharge for his substat is also very important, both increasing the speed at which Xingqiu's burst generates on and off field to ensure after 20 seconds we can reactivate his burst. Due to the necessity of this stat, his best alternatives will be those that provide energy recharge, whatever weapon they may be. Favonia Sword being the next best alternative, being able to generate additional neutral particles upon critical hits, but only when on field. Beyond these options, a crit rate or damage weapon will help Xingqiu deal more damage, though because of the drop-off in energy recharge potential, the drop-off in my recommendation for these weapons is also quite high. While his damage is quite important to his overall performance, more often than not, his Hydro application will be his primary use, solidifying the necessity to have as much energy recharge as possible. In conclusion, Xingqiu is a powerful burst support capable of setting up your main DPS for optimal success while also standing strong as a high damage dealer in his own right. Although his performance can lack, under proper investment and gear, his potential will be as high as the birds at the Oceanid boss. Hopefully you guys have found this guide useful and it will help you in building your own Xingqiu. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, like the video, and hit that notification bell, that way you never miss a video. And join our Discord, link will be down in the description below. But guys, that's all I have for today. Hopefully you did enjoy, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.